so tall that there's three clouds. Possible? Perhaps. But remember, my friends, the world is full of magical things. It has been since the beginning. And in the beginning, there were the heavens and the earth. And the earth was a ball, spinning, spinning, spinning through the universe, spinning, spinning. And in those days, centuries before the dawn of man, the world was a jungle, lush and green. And out of the jungle sprung mountains with peaks that rose forever. And there were seas, dark and green, and deserts, hot and black. And there were trees and plants lofting into the clouds. And everywhere there was light. Giant animals roamed the earth in search of food. Huge portions of food to fulfill their massive appetites. Great dinosaurs nibbled the treetops. Woolly mammoths rumbled through the plains and sharpened their tusks on mountainsides. Indeed, the world was full of life and magic. It was a land of giants. A land of mystery. And somewhere, deep in the tropics, there grew the most mysterious plant of all. A bean plant it was, with one long, long branch reaching far into the depths of the hidden cave. And there, in the depths of that dreary cavern, were more of the beans that would shape our story. They were giant beans. They were magic. They were born many long years ago.
There were horses.
cats, and mice, and elephants parading in the circus tent, and the once mighty mountains faded into pastoral hills and peaceful sleeping meadows. Yes, it seemed that all the world had become smaller, smaller, smaller than before. And still, in the depths, the beans slept. Now, as the world was changing, a new creature arrived, and he was to make the world his paradise. And his name, of course, was man. He built homes, and barns, and planted crops. Man became a farmer. And still, in the depths, the beans slept. He took those crops to market. He bartered in exchange. Man became a merchant. And still, in the depths, the beans slept.